Hello students, in our previous lecture we have completed speed and velocity of the motion. We know what is speed, we have what is velocity, what are the difference between speed and velocity, and similarly we have also discussed about distance and displacement. In this lecture we will start with a new quantity which is known as acceleration and motion also, what is uniform motion and non-uniform motion. So first of all, what is uniform motion? Uniform motion. Uniform motion can be defined, let's say if a person is going from point A to B to C to D. This is A, B, C, D. If at any point, let's say at A or B or C or D, if the velocity of that person is same, if the velocity of that object is same, let's say it is 10 meter per second at here and 10 meter per second here and 10 meter per second here, then the body is said to be in uniform motion. That is, when the velocity of a body is equal at any interval, then the body is said to be in uniform motion. Always remember that for calculating the motion, uniform motion, we use velocity and not speed. And similarly, in the acceleration case also, which we will be talking, we will use velocity and not speed, right? So first is uniform motion, the second is non-uniform motion. Non-uniform motion. So if you know uniform motion, then you can easily find out what is non-uniform motion also. But this non-uniform motion, this is also known as accelerated motion. Now accelerated motion is a new term for you. Accelerated motion. Now for calculating the accelerated motion, we need to know the acceleration. Acceleration. Right. Now what is accelerated motion? Let's take an example. If a body started from A, went to B. Here its velocity is 0 meter per second. It reached B and the velocity was 10 meter per second. Then the body reached at C and its velocity increased to 20 meter per second. Now if you see, then this velocity of this object, it is increasing. The body is accelerating. Like when we drive the car, let's say my house is at A. I started accelerating the car at when I reached B, the acceleration, the velocity of the car was 10 meter per second. Let's say this is 2 seconds. After again next 2 seconds, it became 20 meters per second. So the car is accelerating at a uniform pace, right? So what is acceleration? Acceleration is nothing but change in velocity upon time. How it is written? Acceleration is written by, represented by A. Now change in velocity, this, if I have to find the acceleration between A and B, then change in velocity between will be final velocity minus initial velocity. Final velocity is represented by V and initial velocity is represented by U. So V minus U upon T. This is the formula for acceleration. Now what is the SI unit for the acceleration? Velocity unit is meter per second, we calculated it yesterday, and the time unit is second, so it comes out to be meter per second square, or it can be written as meter, like this also, whichever way you like it, you can write it, right? Meter per second square, this is the SI unit of acceleration. Now the one more thing comes to our mind, that whether acceleration, it is a scalar quantity or it is a vector quantity. Now if you remember yesterday when we were talking about speed and velocity, then there was also a question that whether speed is a scalar or quantity or a vector, or velocity is scalar or a vector quantity. In that, what was the formula for speed? It was distance upon time, total distance upon total time. So distance was a scalar quantity, so speed also became a scalar quantity. But velocity was displacement upon time. So as displacement is vector, so the velocity was also vector quantity. Similarly, for acceleration we use velocity, which is a vector quantity. So acceleration is also no doubt a vector quantity, right? If someone asks you, remember this, that it is also a vector quantity. Now the other thing which comes to our mind, that whether acceleration is positive, negative or whatever. Let's take an example. I'm rubbing this part. And remember, accelerated motion is also known as non-uniform motion, right? Let's say a car at point A was at 200 meter per second velocity, right? When it reached B, on reaching B, he started applying brakes and decreased the velocity to 100 meter per second. Let's say the time taken was 10 seconds by that person. So now if I have to find the value of acceleration, it will be final minus initial. So V minus U upon T, V is 100 minus 200 initial upon T is 10. So minus 100 upon 10, it comes out to be minus 10 meter per second square. So acceleration is negative here. So acceleration can be negative also and positive also. And negative acceleration is also known as retardation. There is a term called retardation. And what is the definition of retardation? Negative acceleration is retardation. If I have to ask what is the retardation of this, then I will not use the negative sign. I will simply write it as 10 meter per second square. So the retardation of this body will be 10 meter per second square, right? So what is the definition of acceleration? Acceleration is defined as change in velocity per unit time. That is acceleration. And negative acceleration is known as retardation. Now, what are the types of acceleration now? Let me rub this. Types of acceleration. What are the types of acceleration? The first is, again similar to speed and velocity, it is uniform acceleration. And the second is non-uniform acceleration. There are two types: non-uniform acceleration or variable acceleration, right? So there are two types of acceleration. One is uniform acceleration and other is non-uniform acceleration, also known as variable acceleration. So what is uniform acceleration? If we say a body is moving from A to B, at A it is 0 meter per second, at B it is 10 meter per second. From B to C, it attained a velocity of 20 meter per second. And from C to D, it attained a velocity of 30 meter per second. Time taken here is 2 seconds. Here is also 2 seconds. Here is also time taken is 2 seconds. So we can see that if I have to calculate the acceleration from A to B, it will be 10 minus 0 upon 2. It is 5 meter per second. A to B acceleration is equal to 10 minus 0 upon 2. It comes out to be 5 meter per second square, right? Acceleration for A to C. A to C, 20 minus 0, total time is 2 plus 2 upon, so 4, it is again 5 meter per second square. From A to D, 0, 30 final initial is 0, 30 minus 0 upon total time is 2 plus 2 plus 2, 6, it comes out to be again 5 meter per second square. So as you can see that acceleration at any point is equal, is same, it does not change, so the body is said to be in uniform acceleration. So uniform acceleration can be defined as if the body moves with an equal if the body has an equal acceleration at equal interval of time, then the body is said to be in uniform acceleration, right? Now the second part is, what is non-uniform acceleration? So for the non-uniform acceleration, what we will do, we will take this example only. Let's say from D to E, it becomes 40 meter per second at E, but the time taken here is total, let's say 4 seconds. Now from A to D we have calculated, but if we have to calculate from A to E, acceleration for A to E will be 40 is the final, initial is 0, 40 minus 0 upon 2 plus 2 plus 2, 6, 6 plus 4 is 10, so it comes out to be 4 meter per second square. Now you see that for A to E the acceleration has changed. So we say that now the body has a non-uniform acceleration as it is not same. So how do we define uniform and non-uniform? Uniform acceleration is defined if the velocity changes at equal intervals of time, then the body is said to be uniform acceleration. But if the velocity changes at equal intervals with unequal intervals of time, then the body is said to be in non-uniform acceleration. Then the body is said to have a non-uniform acceleration, because as we have calculated it from A to E, the acceleration is different. But till, so we can say that from A to D, the body was in a uniform acceleration state, but as soon as it moved from D to E, it became in the non-uniform accelerated state, right? So these are two types of acceleration. Now let us discuss some examples of this, solve some questions of this related to acceleration. Now there is a unit, questions are given, and the question says that first is, when will you say that the body has a uniform acceleration and a non-uniform acceleration? I have just told you, if the velocity of a body changes in equal parts with equal intervals of time, then the body is said to have a uniform acceleration. But if the velocity of a body changes in equal parts but in unequal intervals of time, then the body is said to have a non-uniform acceleration. I have given you the examples also, right? Second question says that a bus decreases its speeds from 80 km per hour to 60 km per hour in 5 seconds. Find the acceleration of the bus. So it is given that a bus moving at 80 km per hour came to 60 km per hour, and the time taken was 5 seconds. We have to calculate the acceleration. So what will you do? You will simply minus this and divide by 5. Right? then the question you will get 0 marks for that. Why? Because I have told you earlier also, you have to be careful about the units. As you see, the speed, this velocity, it is given in kilometer per hour and the time is given in second. Either change it to hour or either change it to meter per second. So we will change it to meter per second. So this is u. U is equal to 80 kilometer per hour. I have told you how to change it to meter per second. 80 into 5 by 18. This will be meter per second. Right? V will be 60 kilometer per hour. It will be 60 into 5 by 18 meter per second. So this is u, this is v, and time is 5 seconds. So acceleration will be v minus u upon t. A is equal to, v is 60 into 5 by 18 minus 80 into 5 by 18 by time is 5. 5 by 18 I take it common. 60 minus 80 upon 5, it comes out to be 5 by 18 into 20 into minus 20. Remember, minus sign will come upon 5. It gets cancelled out. It becomes 10. It becomes 9. Then the acceleration comes out to be minus 1.1 meter per second square. This is the acceleration which we will get. If they are asking us retardation, then we will not apply the minus sign. So the acceleration will be minus 1.1 meter per second square. So easy question. Let's move on to next question now. Next question is given that a train starting from a railway station and moving with uniform acceleration attains a speed 40 km per hour in 10 minutes. Find its acceleration. So what is the question? Question says that a train started from the station. Let's say this point is A. And at certain point, moving with uniform acceleration attains a speed 40 km per hour. 40 km per hour, and the time taken is 10 minutes. It started with 0 km per hour. Right? Now again, if you see, then the units we have to make equal. So what we will do? This is V. V is equal to 40. For making it to meter per second, we multiply it by 5 by 18. We get 29. So we get 100 upon 9 meter per second is the velocity. Time is 10 minutes. Change it to seconds. 10 into 60 is equal to 600. Seconds. Right? Now what we have to do? We have to calculate the acceleration. Acceleration will be v minus u upon t. V is 100 upon 9 minus 0 upon t is 600. So it comes out to be 100 upon 9 into 600. We cancel it out, it comes out to be 1 upon 54 meter per second square. So this is the value of acceleration. So what is the acceleration? It is 1 upon 54 meter per second square. 40 kilometer per hour, we change it on 10, if we calculate it by 10, 6. Yes, so the acceleration came out to be 1 by 54 meter per second square. So this was the question from the exercise of NCERT. In this lecture, only up till here. We will start with the new topic in the next lecture. So thank you very much.